गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस सेशन। ड्यू टू एनी मेडिकल इमरजेंसी ऑन यस्टरडे आई एम अनेबल टू टेक योर क्लास। ओके, बट नाउ आई एम हेयर टू टेक योर रिज्यूम योर क्लास ऑन लिस्ट फंक्शन वी कवर ऑन यस्टरडे। ऑलराइट, सो एनीवन कंफर्म मी दैट यू आर गेटिंग माय स्क्रीन एज वेल एज माय वॉइस टू। Okay, thank you, Ajiz. So let's start the session where we left on Python list. Then from there we will start. All right. I hope all of you coming over here. 24 people are there. All right. That's good. Okay. So where we left in the thing of list, what do we do? Let me revise the thing. First of all, I explained the data structure in last class. Then Python list, what is list, how to create a blank list, then how to create a numeric list, how to create a string list, how to create a mix or hybrid list. All right, so how to do the iteration with the help of for loop, okay, using the values and using the index as well as the value. Okay, then we have the slicing or indexing of this list. I told you that you have the positive index as well as you have negative index. Okay, very important thing, list is mutable, means we can modify the item and we try to update this thing with the help of assignment, means any existing index is there which has some particular value and we can reassign the value. Okay, so that we can say it's a mutable. Okay, now we do the slicing same way the slicing is done when we have string slicing. Just like a start and a stride, you can see it's a step size like that. So this thing we cover on last time. Today I am going to cover, today is January 7, yes, and I'm going to cover the list library function, very important. All right, then we do the list program. All right, so one by one, I am explaining the function of list, very important function, just like those functions which already I explained, just a kind of string, same here we have some function. This function play an important role, okay? So let's start one by one. All of you having a Jupyter today? All of you having a Jupyter today? Okay. So anyone new in this session? Very first class? Anyone very new in this session? All right. I'm going to start a library function. Cell list library function. All right, very important thing. I hope you will pay attention and learn this thing. Library function. Okay, let's see one by one and do this thing. Okay, first library function for a list is append. Append function. What this do? I mean, actually, append is written with the help of a small one. Okay, what append function do? This will, this method or this function is used to insert the item at the end of list. And let someone try to enter in the class. All right, so what happened with the help of this function, we have to put the data at the end of the thing, at the end of the list. This function play important role your entire data science. Okay, keep in mind the various thing we don't know in prediction, so we get the prediction and keep put this thing in my list. Okay, for example, if I have some hyperparameter, what is hyperparameter? The values inside passing model. Okay, I mean the machine learning model. Okay, so the accuracy generated by a model, we have to store that in a list. Okay, because so that we can visualize that thing. So we don't know how much value is returned. That's why we use the append function. Because in a list, it's a dimension free. Dimension free means you need not to fix its size. Okay, so that's why list importance is very much. Okay, so what append function do? It will insert the item at end. For example, I have list, I mean somewhere, I just copy the previous list somewhere, it is creating like this list 3. Okay, just using this thing for example. okay, this is my list 3 and I want to append one more data item. So I take list 3 dot append, then I have to take in, I mean, I will tell you the way how to insert the thing at particular index, not at the end. But by default, append method do insert at the last. Okay, I just put the India. Okay, so in the list of country, you see already we have 4 index. And when I append one more data, that is a country name India, it will be appended at the last. So based on this one, what I'm trying to do, write a program, which store the cube of number from 1 to 10, okay, in a blank list. Okay, so what I do, how I do check this thing. So what happened, I initialize the list. Let's suppose I take the num equal to blank. This is my blank list. Okay, check carefully, especially freshers. Okay, so what I have, the object, write a program which store the cube of number. Whatever the number you provided, it do the cube and store the list. So at last, I will fetch my num list. Okay, this contain the data from 1 to 10, which have the cube, just like 1 cube 1, 2 cube 8, 3 cube 9. All right, so what I do for I in range 1 to 11, I in range 1 to 11, all right, then very simple, num dot append, I take I power q. So double asterisk known as the power operator. You know the knowledge of the operator. So when you have this kind of data and you print the list, so you got this thing. Means one by one, the value is calculated and it is appended at the list. So first time I value is 1. So Q is generated, append over here. I value is 2, Q is generated. So there is no fixed length. How much data you want to keep, you can keep this one. Okay. So append function very useful. Whenever any case is encountered, you can put this thing. Alright, similarly, write a program which filter or check any even number from given list, then filter those number. Filter or then store those number which is divided from 6 in another list. Means what happened? We have a given list with data, so we have to filter those number. Write a program which check the any even number, not even number. So I am checking the even number. So I will do store the even number. When I checking the even number, so we have to store the even number. So just let me store the number. So we are from 2. Even means 2. Okay, not 6. Alright. So what happened? I am creating a list. Num equal to any number, I mean randomly 33, 22, 1. 45, 44, 66, 67, 88, 89. Okay, so we have some numbers. What we have to do, we have to, till now what we do, see, we don't have any storing capacity. So till now what we do, we just do print. But here, we have to get them and allocate them in a different list. Okay, all right. So how we do this thing? We take again for I in, so I just take one more list, even, okay, and that I put the blank, this one is blank, for I in range, what I do, I just check the num, directly pick the value. All right, if I modulus 2, see, logic is same, but the storing criteria is changed. Firstly, we display, now we just storing. I take even dot append, then what am I storing? I am storing the I. Let's check what happening with that. Okay, see, there is no even, no print capacity, no print print function is there. We just do even. So ultimately, what list support you? List support the functionality that you can store the thing in another way. Okay, so append function plain important. Okay, now move to next function, count. Count function. This function used to how many times? Many times the items appears in the list. Okay, indirectly way it will return you the count. Okay, so let me check any item is repeated. Not, it is not repeated. So what I do here, I just make with this list one more time and repeat some item. 33 22 11, let I repeat these item. Okay, so if I want to see any item is repeated or not, so what I do, I just pass the item. Okay, it will take the value. This will take the value and return you the count. All right, means you have to supply the value and it will return the count. So I take num dot count. Let's suppose any number which is not present over here. So let's see, it says count 0. Okay, another, if any number present over there, let's suppose 33 is repeated 2 times. Okay, so 33, just 2. So using this thing, you see, we easily count thing. Otherwise, we have to iterate a for loop, we have to match the value, we have to increase the counter. So instead of doing these work, the count function enable you to return a count. Either it is item is not present, it will return the 0. If item present, so it will give you how many times the item is going to be repeated. All right. Now, third function, this is a first function is append, second is count. Second one is count and C is small. All right. Now, and we have third function is index. Index function. What this function do? This function used to show the lowest index. Lowest index. Why the mean of lowest index? Okay. What does it mean? Let's suppose if any item is repeated multiple times, so it means that is on 2 index. For example, if I show the here same num list, okay. So what happened? If any item is given over here, and I want that 11 on which index, so it will give the 2, 0, 1, 2. But what happened if I search the 33? So 33 is on 2 place, this one and this one. So what happened? It will give you the lowest index. Okay. So num dot index what be 33. Only one index, that is lowest index. All right. Any item higher on place, that is 88. Or 7th. So by this index function, you can easily search the item. Now, method number 4, insert. Okay, this will take the index, comma data. The two parameters will accept. Is this function is used to insert data on desired place. All right, what it do? It just take the data and desired place. Alright, okay. Yes, so yes, first I give you the example. So I have num. So you know, zeroth index, first index, second index. When I insert any item on a particular place, so these all items going to be shift. Alright, for example, this is zero index, this is one index, second index. Whatever I will put on second index, new item. So all those index after this will be shift one place, right? And automatically the dimension is increased by one. And here you find the 11. This 11 you find over here. All right, let's see. Okay, here I want to insert 555, 555. Okay, so what I do, num dot insert. Okay, I want to put the data on second index. So first say index, then data. And on second index, I want to put 555. Okay, when you access this list, so you can get the 555 on this way. Okay, so previously list was a little bit lesser. Now it is increased by the one unit because the one item is going to be inserted. All right. Now, pop function. Fifth function, pop function. Pop function. First of all, what is pop? We should know these are the stack operation. This function is used to remove the last item from list. See, I told you the subject data structure. What is a pop? What is the concept of pop? See, in data structure, we have a stack. Okay, a stack support push means insert, push means insert, and pop. This is basically, this is, I'm showing you the concept. Pop, remove last item. Item. Okay, in data structure we have a stack support push and pop item, means whenever we have to support the last item, okay, so by default it will remove the last item until you don't put any kind of index over here. Let's see the example. We have num, all right, this thing over here. So if I put the pop, num dot pop, nothing I am going to explain over here, nothing I have to putting any index over here. So what happened? It will give you the last item, 11. And this list lost the 11. Okay, 22 is there, 11 is removed. But if I put the pop with an index, so num pop, I put the 2. On 2, we have 0, 1, 2, 555. So what happened? This will give you, means what? It shows the 555 is deleted from your list. And now if you want to display the list, you can see over here that 555 is going to be removed. So basically using a pop function, you can remove this thing done by the del keyword also. Now when we're talking about the removal of item, so we have to talk about the del keyword. Del keyword. See, del is not function, this is keyword. Whenever you put before any indexes, I mean list indexes, so it will remove. This del keyword is used to remove the item from list. All right, let's see how it works. So let's suppose I have num. Actually, I just take the backup of num because rather than create new and new list, I will perform. Okay, so all the things we have in num, now we have temp. Okay, so what I do, I take the del temp of 2. What we have on 2? We have 11. Okay, so when we do this thing and print the temp, the 11 is removed. After 22, you have 45. After 22, you have 45. Okay, 11 is removed from this one. Okay, so this is the one thing which you remove the thing. Okay, if you want to remove some range start to end, okay, so I just put del temp I want to start my list 3 to 7. All item going to be delete. Okay, so what we have on 3, what we have on 7? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, let's see. So 44 and 89, keep this mind and check what happened exactly with this del keyword. So when you run this thing and print the temp, so keep in mind, last index never be attempted in Python. Keep in mind, last index never be attempted, either delete everything. Okay, so whatever it is, 44 to 88, it will be deleted. After 45, we have 44. So using this one, you can remove. Okay, one more thing. If you want to remove entire list over here, so you put the del and the temp. So this will be removed. No message there. But if you access that list from memory, which is deleted from memory, it will give you the error, the name temp is not defined, like that. Okay, so keep in mind, del keyword is used to remove the item over there. Now we have pop, we have del, now we have a remove method. Okay, check this one, what it's showing. Remove method, what is number 5th, and this is 6. This is not exactly method, but this is a way how we delete the data from this tell keyword. Now it's a 7. Remove. Okay, later on I will ask you the difference between pop, remove and del. Okay, so keep this clear. It remove or delete data from list. All right, if multiple copies of item, of object, of data, but data in the list, then the first value is deleted. Okay, so if you have multiple data, so lower index, okay, because it is scanning from the index over 0 to length minus 1. Okay, so, okay, now let's see. Num, I have num. So I'm just taking the backup of num in temp. Okay, so what happened? I just take num dot remove. All right, one more thing that in pop methods, see the difference. In pop method we pass nothing, so it will remove the last item, or we pass the index. I just try it over here so that you can it accept nothing as parameter. Or accept index of data for removal. All right, now either it accept nothing or accept the index. But what in the case of remove? It accept the value. Okay, first difference, it accept the value and pop method accept the index for removal. All right, let's see how it is working. So num.remove, I want to remove 45. Okay, I don't care where is 45 in my thing. Okay, so it will start scanning from one end. If 45 two times, so it will delete the first one. Okay, let's see. 45, then I press that. So the 45 going to be deleted. So these are small things you have to keep in mind. If someone asks what is the difference between remove and the pop method, you can have this kind of thing. Okay, now let's just grow my list. My list going to become small. So I just take again this kind of list. Okay, Now we have, after 7, we have 8th number method. Reverse. Okay. What this do? This will reverse the list. Okay, whatever you given over here, it will reverse the thing. So num equal to, I will put this thing over here, and I put num dot reverse. So what happened? If you check this one, num, see the last item, put it over first, the second item, put it over second over here. Just indexing is shuffled to last to first. Okay, so accordingly the data is going to be shifted over here. So if you want to put the reverse thing, use the reverse method. Okay, method number 9, sort. This method is used to sort the data. Okay, so what we do, again I'm just taking a backup of num. Where is my num? Actually it is reverse, so I'm not going to be reverse. I just copy the original one and paste over here. Then num dot sort. So check this one, what is num? 11 22 33. So what happened? We have a reverse sort. Reverse sort means this is ascending, means lowest entry very first and the highest entry very last. So what we happen if I want to put 89 very first, 89, 88, that, so first sort then reverse, or otherwise what happened? We have to use one keyword inside this num dot sort. What that keyword? So one keyword, reverse equal to true. This is shift tab. If you want to see documentation, put the cursor over here, shift tab. Okay, so you can put the reverse equal to false. So reverse equal to true. So reverse equal to, the sorting is done in such a manner that biggest value is come first and the least value come last. Check this one, sort then reverse, or put reverse equal to true, then same thing over here. All right, now the extend, this is number 10, extend. All right, what we have extend, this method is used to add the element in the list to the end of another list. Means you have two lists and you want to put entirely one list at the end of another one. So what we do, let's suppose I have a num1 equal to this what one, num2 equal to what one. Okay, so I just split some content from here and put over here, and again I take some content over here and put over here. Okay, now what happened? I want to extend the num1, so the content of num1 will modify, not num2. So what happened? I want to extend num1 with num2, means content of num2 will be picked, the content of num1 will be picked and put over at the last of this one. Okay, let's see how we do this thing. So I'm running this thing, num1 dot extend. What I put? Num2. Okay, see the content of num1, it is going to modify, and what is the num2? It remains same. So thing is that which list you going to be extend? I'm extending num1, so content of num1 will modify, and by the list you are extending, it will be appended at the last. Now one program, write a program. So just I am giving a data first. Okay, so what I do, I give you a list of email. I mean, there may be 1,000 or 500, but I take here the fourth one. Jed@gmail.com. Okay, so what I want to do from your side, okay, what I write a program to extract the username from your name of those person whose email ID on Gmail and store these name in another list. Okay, what I do, I just put all the things in chat box. So what person is asking, sir, what the number belonging to the highest index have to remove using the remove? I mean, not getting you. Ganesh, can you please unmute yourself and ask me once again, what the number belonging to highest index? Ganesh, please, I mean, not getting you. What the number belonging to the highest index have to be removed using remove? So you've gone through the pop the value, because remove will start indexing from zero. Okay, so I'm giving you this thing, this listed here. Okay, so Ganesh, can you send me some code snippet to what you want to do? See, remove will scan from left to right, means zero index to highest index. So wherever the value is picked up, it will delete that thing. Or better, you take the for loop and do this thing. So how many value is there, remove will identify that thing and remove one. But I think when you do the remove, see one thing, I encounter somewhere, if you have not a value, just like in num what we have, actually num is going to modify. So what we have in num, and if we don't have the 101, so num dot remove 101. So this is a problem with the remove. Okay, because if you don't have value, so you can't remove that thing. Okay, it will give you the error. That is a problem with the remove also. Okay, so better you put this thing in loop, and how many time loop will hit that value, it will remove that one. All right, so give me this answer. Okay, just in 1 minute. Yes, any program from any side? How to check the username of that person which is email ID on Gmail? Savisachi, yes, send your solution, send your code. Savisachi is there? Oh, okay, okay. Anyone give the solution? So I insist that to share the screen that other participant. Now I just take the name because I forgot the name. Ashish Solanki.
Trying, sir.
Okay, just do this thing. Very good thing. Bivor, Shweta, Shubhangi. One more participant is here. I just forgot their name. Email del12. Shweta, you run this solution. So you fix the index. Let's suppose if we have 500 emails or 10,000 emails. Wow, you are joking here. If you have 500 emails and out of whatever you have only 200 Gmail. So you just try to put manually indexes. I just use a general logic. User equal to 1 for j in I. ओके आपने ये ले लिया बेटा, आपने जीमेल कहाँ चेक किया है गणेश? माय प्रॉब्लम इज फॉर जीमेल नॉट एट द रेट, वी हैव टू चेक द जीमेल थिंग, वी हैव टू यस आशीष गणेश
सर कैन वी
वन 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 मिनट वन मिनट गणेश, वी हैव टू चेक ओनली द जीमेल पर्सन, यू डोंट गो द प्रॉब्लम, माय प्रॉब्लम इज दैट नॉट एट द रेट, एक्सट्रैक्ट द यूजर नेम, आई वांट टू एक्सट्रैक्ट द ए, देन आई वांट टू एक्सट्रैक्ट द यूजर नेम, मे बी आई मीन दिस सैंपल यूजर नेम ए, देन वी हैव टू एक्सट्रैक्ट द डी, देन वी एक्सट्रैक्ट द जेड, द लिस्ट विल कंटेन, द न्यू लिस्ट कंटेन ओनली थ्री एंट्री ए then D, then J. Better I put the name over here. Chetan and D for DK, maybe new. From J, I just put the Manoj, M-A-N-O-J, and here I put the Brijesh. Now perfect. I want the name. Username. See, in domain you have first a username, then domain name. So I want to extract those username which are belong to Gmail. That's a thing which I want. Your code is specific about the at the rate, not the Gmail. Yeah, Ashish, now it's your turn. You can ask me.
Sir, can we start? जैसे अगर किसी को start करके करते हैं ना अपन किसी के अंदर.
Start नहीं, speed लग जाएगा.
नाम से मेरे को
स्प्रिट लग जाएगा, स्प्रिट स्ट्रिंग मैंने फंक्शन बताया. देखो मैं कैसे करूंगा, देखो लेट्स सी, आई एम कैचिंग द फर्स्ट एंट्री ईमेल एट द रेट जीरो, ओके सॉरी ईमेल जीरो, सो आई गॉट दिस वन, ओके देन आई डू द स्प्लिट, लुक हियर आई डू द स्प्लिट, स्प्लिट फ्रॉम विच एट द रेट, सो आई विल गॉट टू एंट्रीज, फर्स्ट वन इज दिस वन, सेकेंड वन, सो आई हैव टू कैच दिस वन, ओके I have to match the condition. See, if I have to match the condition from Gmail, so I have to catch the one thing over here. So this will return you Gmail. Okay. Now, see what I'm trying to do. I take for I in email. Okay. And initializing one list username equal to. Just wait. Let me do the thing. Okay. You have done the solution. That's good. Let me. Okay. So first thing you try to. See how we do this thing. I just take first entry from this one. First of all, try to catch Gmail. Second, what I do, I just do the split. Which one? This one, the first entry. Or split at the rate. So once you get this one, so you will get two entry. If you want to check the username, so you have to put over here the zero because it gives you the collection zero and one. Okay. So what I do, from zero, you get the username. And from one, you get the domain name. Okay. So everything I show you is by splitting one by one. All right. So now I'm building my logic. For I in email, what I do, I check if, see, I contain which value? This value. Because it is a indexing from this one. Okay. So I, what I do, then split. I have to call a Gmail. So I do split this one dot split equal to Gmail. Fine. This is my condition is checked. Now what I do, UN means username, what I created over here dot append. Now what I have to append? I have to append the username means this one. So I have to check this one once again. I control V, I dot split from at the rate where is the problem? Is split not is split? Which is okay? I dot split is split. Now, if you check the UN, that's the thing which I want. General logic is there. Okay, so I'm just giving you programs to your side. What Sovic says, that's maybe solution. Split. If J in this one, what to do? Yeah, Sovic, that's what. Last one is supported. Okay, so as you wish, what to do? Okay, now I'm moving to next function. My next function is enumeration. Very good function is there. So it is in sequence of 10, 11. Enumeration, what is very good function? This function is used to return both the index as well as data. Till now, what we do, we are maintaining a range, etc., etc., which return one thing at a time, either return a value or return an index. Okay. So let's suppose I have this kind of email. I want to see on which index which data is there. All right. So what I do? This is my email. I just put this thing by entering.
Sir, this side Shovik.
Yes, Shovik. Yes, please. Yes, please. Any query?
Can you repeat the last one because I was busy in trying.
This one. This.
Yeah. That's so,
okay. See what I do first of all. First of all, I get the first email. You please unmute yourself. My voice is echoing to me. Okay, first of all, I get the first email from this list. I got this one from Jira index. Then I do split from @ because this is a string. So a string support the split. I do the split. Then I got the first one. If you want, because it is returning two values, 0 and 1. On 0, I have a username, and 1, we have the domain name. So I check 0. That is username which I require, and on 1 a Gmail which is matching condition. So same thing, I maintain a blank list. I get one web an email. I check because here is email in my I value because it is a catching a value. I do a split from @ and check one index. Which one? This one. Is it Gmail? Yes, if this is Gmail, so take blank list, append the value with the username which is 0th index. I just check with the first index, domain name, and appending the username. That's it. And when you have this thing, so you have three users which contain the value of Gmail ID. First one is Abhishek, second one is DK, third one is Manoj. A simple logic is here. Got it, Shovik?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, the enumeration. This will give you the function return your index as well as the value or data. I mean, value, data, same thing. So, right now, what we do, we just fetching the value with the for loop either returning an index or returning a value, but not both case. But if you want to get both thing in the both case, so what we do, we just take the enumeration and we take the list over here for index comma value in enumerate which one email the list name. Okay, then what I do, I just put print value comma is at index, then what index I maintain, check this one. So it is catching, see this function taking a list. And this is returning two things. The first parameter is index and second parameter is value. Okay. So what I do print the value first and I do print the index later on. So what happened? The first thing you get the value and second thing you got the index over here. Okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So this is a very important function and use many times when you want to do find the collection and collection you find range. So the index as well as the value. Okay, now 12 list comprehension. What is that? Means we can generate the list value from expression. How? Okay. List comprehension. Comprehension. Okay. All right. So what happened? We have to generate the value with the help of any expression. So I just take the cube. Cube equal to C. I raised to the power 3. Okay. So from where I get the value for I in range 1 to 11. So 1 by 1, it will give you the value of I. And this will store the cube in that value, and you can just simply print the cube. Very simple. So here is the expression I put over here. This expression was a comprehension. Based on this comprehension, you can generate this one. Okay, let's see one more example. We take even equal to again I. Sorry, 2 into I. I just multiplying the value. Okay, for I in range, what range? 1 into 11. Print the even. Check this one. It is supplying the I value each time you are multiplying 2, and data is created over here. So this is again list comprehension. Now, again, check this one. One more condition. Over here, I just multiplying these value and check these value. If I modulus 3 equal to 0, means I am getting those value it is generated by 1 to 10 by for loop, then I multiply those all value from by 2, and those value which is divisible from 3, those all the things, this is 3 divided from 3, this is divided from 3, that value permitted over here. I just put the if condition. So you can see in entire one expression, I just write the thing, means condition and expression which generating the value. That is a list comprehension. Now, how to convert? Convert.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, Ashish.
Yeah, Ashish.
Sir, can we use multiple for loop or if loop in this list?
Definitely. But right now I have don't example. I will see some example on internet. Okay, scenario. Then you see, comprehension means you have valid expression. So valid expression can generate anything over here.
Okay.
So how to convert a list to a string? See what I'm trying to say. In list, you have multiple scattered thing, and an string you have one entity means joined with one. Okay. So I just take alphabet. Alphabet equal to A, B, C, D, E. This is my list. Right? And I have to convert the string. So this will be one entity. If you convert any string. Okay. So what I do, I just take str from alpha. I will do combine all the things. So what I do, I take the join function, join, then I pass the alpha. So what I am doing here, I just take this one alpha over here, and this will take every character from here and will join without any space, means A without any space, B without any space, C, D, E, and F. That's the thing, it will join, and you got at the end one string entity. Okay, if you want to check the type, because my type will clearly explain you what is that, the list. All right. So keep in mind, I mean, sometimes we have a scenario to clubbing them all, splitting them all. So you have to do this kind of thing. All right. Now, reciprocal to thing, how to convert a string to list. We have a string, same thing. We have to convert this thing into list. So what we do? We take any temp, this thing. Okay. Now what I'm trying to do, list is a function which try to convert everything into list format. Okay. So I pass here the temp. Check this one. So it will again scatter the thing. So this is a way you switching between string to list means collection become the single entry. This collection become the single entry. Okay, and then single entity become the collection, scattered form. So you have to check this thing over here. Okay, so based on this thing, I'm just giving you some program, just like actually I will keep this program in a homework. Okay, so let's talk about what you get from the notes as a notes and what I'm giving you the solution, what you're giving the homework based on this one. This thing, where is notes? Yeah, this one is here. The function part 2 contain 35 programs. If someone see the last one. See. These are the 35 program. I just take the printout of any paper. Okay. And then I put the math function with functionality. So these program have the solution this year. Now Sunday I will release this thing. I was released this thing. You can see everything overwritten over here. You guys do, you have to request it to do all the things because I am providing a solution. Somewhere mistakes, so please correct it up. Okay, then we have a string library function. And I thought I put some program also. Yeah, homework. Any string also. Okay, so in here, in this file, I hope all the data is given or not. All data not given. Okay. So I will provide the solution of this one also. So you guys keep practicing on this one. Then after giving the string homework, I will give you the list homework. Approximate 15 to 20 programs are there. So that why intention behind this giving this program? So that you can work on these kind of library function. All right. So a good number of program is there. So you can keep practicing. Yes. Now it's a query session. If you have any query regarding this class, so you can ask me. Yes, Abhisachi, welcome you.
Yeah, can you just show me that last split one that were that program of split that page that name username from the email? Because I did that thing, I got some.
I think this is a very burning program. Everyone asking for this. Okay, let's check this one. This one.
Last one. Yeah. So that output even is equal to you created
username. I just matched the condition and stored the username.
Yeah, I did the same, but you know, I got something.
Kindly paste the code. Mm-hmm. I just checked. Yes, let me check.
Now,
let me check.
No word.
So So we have to put also list over here. Let me check the list. So what happened? It will give you two data. I mean, Gmail is there, but what happened?
Yes.
Actually, you take the list one first of all. The list is a function keywords. Okay. So do not use this one. Okay. Let me check. So what happened? I take the email. If I equal to Gmail, append I dot split. I mean, same thing is there. List one.
Sir, actually, where he has written list dot append I dot split. In the bracket, he has written.
Yes.
So he has to split it
after the delete. He should close the braces.
My audience is very intelligent. Perfect. My audience is very intelligent. The teacher not pointing out the mistake, but audience. That's why we have a team. Okay. The teamwork is always appreciated. All right. Not me, not you. I mean, we have a collecting 30 people, 40 people. We do can do all. Okay. So I'm going to finish.
Can you scroll down this screen, sir?
Yes, please. How much?
Yes, this one. List comprehension, yes, please. Can we apply this Gmail example to this list comprehension, sir?
How? What do you want from this one from me? Actually, here the expression is given and evaluation is done. So how we apply this one? I mean, I don't know how to apply this one.
My doubt is, can we apply? That's my doubt.
No. Actually, the expression contain the value. Actually, here the collection is. You can do this thing. You can do this thing. But how we do this thing? We have email. But there is a long, very long expression is here. Okay, I will let you know tomorrow because we can do everything. Okay.
Definitely.
Anyone can do this thing. Very challenging task is there because we have collection. Collection is email. You have to pick data one by one because we have for loop over here. And then we check. Yeah, let's try. If you ask me, let's try. I don't know. I'm wrong or. Okay, let's try. Okay, guys, this is completion. Very good question. What is your good name? It's Venkatesh.
Venkatesh.
This is your first class.
Yes, this is my first class. I got output as a none, something like that.
Okay, so what do we do? I just take here blank list. Okay, UN1. All right. Okay.
This is my code, sir. I tried it, but I got none, something like that.
Let me try for I in email. See, we have collection over here. Email. Now. What we have to put if. Not I am putting the I. Yeah, I can try because very heavy expression will be there. I is generating a sequence. All right. So
we can put un dot append I word that.
Sir, I shared my.
Append will not be doing here because it is automatic generating comprehension. Append will not work because it is automatic generating.
Okay.
Yeah, can you share the code? Then we see.
Yes, sir. I shared it in chat box.
Okay. Oh, you do the append one.
Yes, append.
So what is the use of append when list comprehension creating item? So no need to append. See this example.
Also use only dot split.
See.
I dot
split. See. Where we just not creating any append, we not putting any comma, and this is generating one. Okay, so let me try the thing.
We can simply use I dot split at the rate.
Try it and take.
Yes, sir. I got the output, sir. I got the output.
How?
I just removed the append and the append syntax, and I got the output.
Yes, yes.
That someone failed, sir.
Put over here.
Yes, this is the condition.
Everything is working on this. I put this one. Yes, because the pen will not give you.
Something. Yes, yes. Someone suggested me that remove the pen, so I got there.
Yeah. All right. Very good. I mean, this everything. I mean, comprehension become complex thing. Okay, so we have to test data manually. See what I do, why I do you this thing manually, because the all person know what I'm trying to do. So one thing is explicitly write it over here, put it over here, then I put my logic over here. All right. So you guys also intelligent enough can do this thing. I mean, one time consolidated like, logic cannot be created, but one by one.
The entire, like all those ready mail and all such, because you have.
Please repeat your question. Please see what you're trying to say.
I'm asking that what is written in username,
mm-hmm.
it return me the output that A, B, C, D, all things are there, A, B, C, D, Z. Because we cannot check the condition that at the rate and gmail.com is also there.
So, but my condition is gmail.com, nothing else. So what do you want?
No, to no, list comprehension.
Okay.
I got the output as A, B, C, D, Z, right?
Yes. And what is your data?
But it should be A, B, D.
If you have one more if condition is there.
Yeah.
One more if condition. So I will try. Okay, I'll let you know tomorrow. All right. Because this is smart programming. The good programmer use this kind of syntax. Okay. They do all the thing in one code rather than writing multiple line code. All right. Okay. So, any more things? So, yeah, you can finish the session. Thank you so much. Muthu Kumar, actually, I am unable to do this thing like a Slack, Telegram. You should communicate this thing to the management. Okay. I will communicate. I just take the screenshot of this one. I will communicate to my management part. And whatever they want to do, a contact person. If anyone regarding class able to get the aware of same, because no student number. Okay, I just take the Muthu Kumar. I just take this one, the screenshot. I forward this to management because I am not beyond the management. Whatever they guide, I am here for teach you. Okay, so you have okay. What I do, I just take any contact number. Muthu Kumar and display on tomorrow, so that rather than email, you have immediate assistance from them. All right, thank you. That's good. Okay, I just take the number, any number, any helpline number, so that they can shorten you your problem. Thank you so much, guys. Good night.